Good morning, welcome to the Sweet Chocolate Thai Boy channel. And today's episode, we are bringing you here right now at the Don Mueang International Airport. And of course that we are exactly at the Coral Executive Lounge. It is on the way for us to go to the gate, because today we are going to Ranong, one of the very good places that we would like to travel there for a very long time, and now it's a good time for us to go there. Alright, and of course today, apart from traveling to Ranong to enjoy ourselves, we're going to do the vlog called Top 10 to-do list before you traveling yourself on board the aircraft. So I am very sure that you're gonna enjoy the vlog today. Alright, now we come to the very top 10 that I have mentioned earlier in regards to the to-do list before you're traveling on the aircraft, okay? When you need to go on the aircraft, traveling everywhere, like domestically, internationally, everything is kind of same drill anyway. So I'm just gonna give you guys the idea what to do, okay? This is the top 10 list to be able to complete and make sure you have done it well. Because if you can do this top 10 list that I have recommended today, I'm sure that every trip, regardless business trip, pleasure trip, everything is gonna be fine for you guys, as long as that you can just prepare yourself very well, things like that, okay? Come to the very first one that you need to make sure that it's complete before the flight. First, passport. Your documentations in regards to passport, ID card, whatsoever, which is certified who you are. That's the most important part that you need to make sure that it's valid. Especially when you need to travel internationally, passport had to be at least 6 months validity from now on. Like for example, you need to travel on the 1st of January, you need to make sure your passport validity will be at least until the end of June, 30th of June, things like that. 6 months, it's kind of basic, but it depends on the on the country you're going to visit, that they accept at least 6 months validity in passport or more than that. So make sure that you comply to those rules of each of the country that you visit to. But if you are traveling domestically, like you are Thai or not, depends. I do believe the ID card, the identifications ID card, it is required to show to the immigration officer or to show to the airliner that you are that person to, like, you know, check in the real one, not the artificial one, things like that, okay? That's number one. And number two, you need to prepare yourself well that all about the baggage, the suitcase that you need to pack. Like, make sure that it's early. For me, as a Sweet Chocolate Thai boy, that like I mentioned before, that I was a cabin crew, so I know well how to, you know, like pack myself whatever I need. Like especially for today, I'm traveling to Ranong with my partner, I mean my cameraman of course, that we did just 15 minutes or 30 minutes last night, and that's it, full stop. And I never miss out anything, but that the expert. But for you guys, that if you hardly travel or maybe not very often, like cabin crew or pilots that we used to do all the time, I would recommend that at least a few days before your departure date, because then that you're not gonna miss out anything. Or if you miss something from your suitcase, at least you know that, okay, I need more medications for myself, I need some kind of like traveling insurance, or maybe extra sweater, extra pants, extra innerwear, extra outerwear, things like that. So prepare yourself early, okay, at least a few days, like 3 to 4 days or up to a week before your departure date of your traveling, okay? And of course, one thing that you need to make sure it's early too, that nowadays it's 2019, so make sure you have checked in the airline early. I'm talking about the check-in online, okay? worldwideweb.blahblah.com, things like that. Like for example, today we're traveling Air Asia, we just check in from the mobile phone applications or even the website at www.airasia.com, things like that. That make sure that you have checked in online early, because to avoid those, disruptions, avoid those problems, headache later, make sure you do things like prepare yourself suitcase well early, checked in online early, okay? And of course, come to number three, It's all about the packaging that we have mentioned, Star. You know, when you need to pack yourself for the suitcase, for the carry-on items, those stuff, that you need to make sure that you know the rules of all the airline regulations, and including the traveling by air. Like I'm talking about the ICAO, FAA, that nowadays that you cannot bring liquids on board. You know that, right? That no liquid gel aerosols, like more than 100 ml, and that, you know, cannot be fit in your carry-on items, things like that. You can do it, but very few amount, not more than 100 ml first, not more than 100 ml second, maximum in the Ziploc, plastic bag Ziploc, transparent, and not more than 10 bottles, okay? Once again, 100 ml each, and not more than 10 bottles in the plastic bag Ziploc. Let's make sure that you can carry this on board the aircraft in your carry-on suitcase or carry-on baggage, but still, sometimes that you may find it headache, like to bring it out, bring it in. So at least pack nicely, show it to the security guard. I'm talking about security screening point. I'm sorry, about security screening point. Make sure that you comply to those rules of each of the airport. Okay, mostly it's all the same all over the world, but still that in Thailand it's pretty strict. I'm sorry, pretty strict, not stiff, pretty strict too. So make sure they comply to those rules. Okay, that liquid gel aerosols couldn't be more than 100 ml to be on board. You know, once you as a carry-on items, things like that. Okay. All right, and now it's come to number four that we did talk about to prepare yourself like early before the flight, things like that. The top three already mentions right now. Now come to number four. That's the make sure that no lithium batteries like contains in your suitcase. I'm talking about the check-in suitcase, okay? Because you can carry it on board. You know about lithium battery, right? Those kind of the, laptop, power bank, those stuff you could carry it on board with you as a carry-on items, but you cannot put it under the aircraft as a check-in bag, okay? Because it could have been endangered to the airline, okay? Especially as an air transport, it's not allowed, okay? So make sure that no lithium batteries, you know, like in your check-in baggage, okay? Like battery from the the power bank did too much, or no power bank, basically no power bank, no laptop, also all about the, you know, the boosted board, those kinds of, you know, like the recharge battery, lithium battery, that could not allow at all, okay, in the check-in baggage under the aircraft, okay? So make sure you don't do that. That's a top four, okay? Now it's come to number five. Number five, we're going to mention about the your carry-on items. I'm talking about the carry-on baggage, you know, that you bring it along with you on the aircraft, okay? And then you put the bags above your head in the overhead compartment or underneath under the seat in front of you, things like that. So normally all the airlines have the same rules, that especially if you're traveling economy class, it's gonna be like 7 kg maximum, okay, 7 kilograms. But if you're traveling in the premium class, probably maybe a little bit more, like 15-20, depends on the airlines, okay? But mostly overall the airlines kind of same, but in economy class at least maximum 7 kg, okay? They would allow you maximum one carry-on baggage and one laptop bag or one personal like woman's bag, things like that, okay? All right, and one thing I need to ensure you guys, apart from number five, I have mentioned the carry-on bag, maximum 7 kg, right? One thing that you need to know that if you are the one who smoke, make sure that you do not smoke on board the aircraft. Whichever airlines in the world nowadays, they do not accept any smoker on board the aircraft. It's a big tampering, you know, like big, you break the rules, a big rules, and it is not allowed at all. Regardless, normal cigarette, electric cigarette, it's not allowed. Okay, you'll be fined maximum like up to $2,000, or you even be jailed in some certain countries or some certain airlines. So that's a big rule. Don't overcross the rules, things like that, okay? So do not smoke. And of course, if you happen to smoke but not on the aircraft, of course, there will be some certain dedicated area for you in the airport, for some certain airport as well. But if you need to carry your lighter, you know about the lighter, you can, but need to make sure that you keep it with you. Not even in your carry-on items, the carry-on baggage, not of course in the check-in baggage, okay? You can keep it with you to yourself only. So make sure that if you carry the lighter, keep it with you, okay? And show it to the security screening point that you have the lighter with you, okay? That is allowed normally, okay? And of course, we come to number 6, okay, that's like we did today, like our flight, it's the departure, like 11:40, when we arrive here, like at least 8 o'clock, like 3 to 4 hours before departure time, especially before the boarding time, because boarding time and departure time is kind of like 45 to hour maximum length that you can wait. Like for example, today we 11:40 as the, you know, departure time. It's 11 o'clock, that's for our boarding time. So apart from 11 o'clock, at least 3 to 4 hours before, make sure that you already at the airport, because to avoid those kind of headache for you, that you will miss the flight, you cannot check in your baggage, you cannot, you know, like, it's a lot of things, a lot of hassles that you will face for sure, the problems, big problems at the airport. So make sure that you are complying already that 3 to 4 hours before even the boarding time, not even departure time. You have to be at the airport already. Like what we did today, we arrived since 8 o'clock, which is 3 hours before the boarding time. Of course, that you will go through everything like smoothly, checked in, baggage loading, immigration, having proper breakfast, enjoy ourselves in the lounge now. It's amazing and it's pretty smooth. So make sure you comply the same, okay? All right, now it's come to number 7. That's before flight, before you're traveling on the aircraft, okay, you need to make sure that you eat, sleep, rest well before. Because even you're not working as a cabin crew like me before, but still as normal passengers, you know, when you travel, it's a lot of energy to be used, and then it's a lot of things to be done. Especially you are on the aircraft, it's a very high altitude, and what to say, it's very like low pressure. It's the weather, it's bad in the aircraft, it's kind of circulation oxygen to be used in the aircraft. If you not rest well, you will be, you know, like come to the kind of a fatigue mode, or even in the mode of sickness very easy, especially motion sickness. If you happen to be the one who's really like, you know, having a motion problems when you're traveling all the time, make sure that you eat, sleep and rest well before the flight. That's very important, okay? And one of the very best thing that I need to ensure you guys, that apart from all the cosmetics, skincare, whatever you're carrying with you, medications, your own medications, that especially the one which is like paracetamol, the one which is for your, you know, allergies to the air, or even when you have a runny nose, you're coughing, even the lotion for your sore throat, everything which is important and pretty simple for you, make sure that you carry it in your carry-on baggage, okay? Because when you're traveling, especially internationally, that the medication is different from all over the world. If you happen to be tired like me, sometimes I cannot enjoy or get recovered by the medications in Trigov, things like that, or even in the USA, things like that, because I am born Thai and I use all Thai medications. I can even go for those kind of like, you know, ginseng or something which is very authentic, organic, things like that. So make sure you have your own medications without a doubt. That will be good for yourself, okay, in case you fall sick, okay? All right, and now it's come to number 8, that you need to stand by yourself at the gate at least 15 minutes to 30 minutes before the boarding time. Like I have mentioned before, that especially for today, our boarding time is 11 o'clock, so at least maximum 11:45, I'm sorry, 10:45, I have to be there at the gate already to just wait for the boarding, because you need to ensure that you are ready for boarding and you pack everything ready. You went to use the toilet properly before you go on board, because you will know, and I will guide you guys later, that as in the aircraft toilet, it's not really like full functional, things like that. So make sure that you use properly already from the airport, okay, the toilet, okay, and then you will enjoy it so much, things like that, okay? So make sure at least 15 to 30 minutes before boarding time, you are already at the gate, ready for boarding. And now it's number 9, that you're ready at the gate already, right? And once you are the one who are eligible or entitled to board already, you make sure you get on the aircraft early. Of course, like especially if you are mother with infant, if you are the one who require assistance, special assistance, you better board the aircraft before anyone else, okay? That's priority boarding. But if you have a chance to be get in the line to board the aircraft already, so make sure that you do one, because once you get settled before anyone else, you we have more space to put your carry-on baggage on the overhead compartment or underneath the seat in front of you. And of course that you can just buckle up, fasten seatbelt, prepare yourself well during the time that people get hassles, come on the aircraft, things like that. So make sure you to the gate early already, right? You board early and get settled everything by yourself. Let's come to number 10, which is very important. Once you get settled already, you buckle up, you just wait for the aircraft to be complete boarding, things like that. And then of course, one thing that I need you guys to understand, that cabin crew, they are there for their job. They are there to support you. They are there to ensure your safety and comfort. So please comply all the rules that cabin crew advise you to do so, okay? Whatever, regardless service, regardless safety, they are there for a reason, right? They're not just serving you tea, coffee. So please ensure that you comply to those rules, especially to the cabin crew instructions, okay? And if you happen to be seated on the exit row, like for us today, we volunteer to be seated on the exit row. That means we sit nearby the exit. In case of something emergency, we have to make sure that we are physically, mentally fit to operate the door or to occupy all emergency drill that the cabin crew would advise you to do so. At the end of the day, regardless that you are ex-cabin crew like me or not, or you are military, you paramedic, you know as well, you're even stronger than cabin crew, the small tiny girl, but still, you're not there for their, your duty. They are there for their duty, so you comply to their regulations and their instructions strictly, okay? That's the thing that I need to remind all you guys. Regardless you are the strong guy or you are not the strong much, things like that, but cabin crew is there for their job. You ensure to comply their rules, okay? Yes, and that's all the top 10 to-do list that you need to prepare yourself before you're traveling on the aircraft, okay? I believe that this episode, more or less, it would help you guys to understand what to do and what to prepare before the flight, okay? But apart from the experience that I have been in already, one thing that, like I told you guys all the time, that this channel, Sweet Chocolate Thai Border, I have a very good attention to make sure that my channel or my knowledge that I am the person like this would help you to have an easier life, or it will help you to at least entertaining you guys that listening to me, watching me to do things like to go, you guys eat, hunt, travel, enjoy, even the cabin crew trick, even the traveling tips, things like that. So hope you guys enjoyed it, okay? So please don't forget to like, share, subscribe my channel, Sweet Chocolate Thai Boy. And then of course, until then, see you guys later. Be safe, be joyful, be happy. Bye.